Now we shall go for next topic, that is various types of addresses that are there. Right. So no, this is what we have seen next. Okay. Yeah. So from this we will see the link layer protocols. Today we are going to study something on link layer protocols. So everybody can hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now we can, what I meant to say, see link layer protocols. Basically, there are three types of link layer protocols. One is called as unicast, and second one is called multicast, and third one is called broadcast. So these three protocols are called as link layer protocols. So unicast is nothing but, you know, from each, what I meant to say, host or a router is assigned a unicast address, right? And the meaning of the word, so any network which is there, in that particular network, every host will have a unicast address, and you know, routers in between intermediate what I meant to say devices called as routers, they will also have a unicast address. The meaning of the word unicast is nothing but one-to-one communication. One-to-one communication means, if a system is A is sending a frame to system B, it is called unicast, what I meant to say, addressing. So directly, what I meant to say, the frame from A goes to B, right? So A has to, on its frame, A has to put unicast address of B and then send it to the destination. So this is what will happen. And how do I identify a unicast address? So unicast address is nothing but generally 48 bits in size, that is 6 bytes in size. And it is represented as 12 hexadecimal digits. Hexadecimal digits means you can see two hexadecimal digits, then two more, four. This is 6 hexadecimal, this is 8, 10, and total, what I mean, say 12 hexadecimal digits. So as such, in a hexadecimal digit, you know that there will be always 4 bits. So this 4 bits and this 4 bits will be 8 bit. 8 bit, first set of 8 bits, second set of 8 bit, third set of 8 bit, fourth set of 8 bit, fifth set of 8 bits, and sixth set of 8 bits. That is 6 bytes will be the total length of what I mean to say, the unicast address. So 6 bytes, 48 bits means 6 bytes, right? And mind well that in unicast address, how do I identify that this is a unicast address? So here, the second, what I meant to say, digit should always be an odd number. So here you can see from leftmost, you know, this thing, we can see 3 is a, which has been colored in red, is an odd number. So whenever there is an odd number in the second position from left, we know that this is a unicast address. So network, whether it is you know, receiving host or a router, the moment it sees an odd value in the second position from left, you got the idea, it understands that it is a unicast address, and this particular frame containing unicast address is meant for me, is meant for me. So this is how it goes about. Now, we have something called as multicast address. So multicast address is common generally in LANs, Ethernets, and all. Again, it is also 48 bits in length, or 6 bytes in length, and it is always presented in 12 hexadecimal digits separated by colons. So here, you can see 2 hexadecimal, again, 4 hexadecimal, 6, then this is 8, 10, 12. So 12 hexadecimal digits are there. Since length of each hexadecimal digit is 4 bits, so 4 into 12, it will be 48 bits, which is nothing but 6 bytes. And they are separated by you know, colons. They are separated by colons, right? And how do I identify that the incoming address or the address sent is a multicast address? Multicast address, the, you know, the second, what I meant to say, hexadecimal digit, whatever is the second digit, whatever is there, it should be an even number. So 2, 4, 6, like even number. So 2, 4, 6, 8, then capital A, then, you know, like, you know, 12, 10, 12, 14, like that it can be. So this is what indicates to a receiving, what I mean to say, host or receiving router, that this is a multicast address. Generally, multicast is one to many. One to many in the sense, not all. You got the idea? One to many means selected number of what I mean to say systems are there to which this will be sent. But what I mean to say here, the condition is multicast address will always have the second digit, hexadecimal digit, to be an even number, right? So second from left is an even number. So this is what is there. So it is one to many communication, but this multicast is again within the local jurisdiction. It cannot go outside the network. Multicast will be within the network. Now, next is a broadcast link layer address. Again, it is most common, LAN or Ethernet. It will also have 48 bits, right? And all the bits will be F, means all will be one, because the hexadecimal equivalent of capital F is 1111. So four ones will be, you know, this thing. So this is hexadecimal equivalent F, right? So F will be always represented in binary form as four ones. So all these digits are ones. You can simply understand that all these digits are ones. So this is the broadcast address. When all the digits in the address are one, so any host or router which receives this kind of frame containing this particular address, it knows that it's a broadcast address. So it is a broadcast address is nothing but one to all communication. One to all means a host will send this to all the hosts and routers that are connected in the network, right? So, you know, this is how we understand. So unicast, second digit from the left, second digit from the left should be always odd, unicast. And second digit, what I meant to say, should be even in multicast. And broadcast, all the bits, all the 48 bits should be one. All the 48 bits should be one. That is what is broadcast address. Now, we will see how exactly the communication goes. So now, suppose a network, what I meant to say, node has a, what I meant to say, IP datagram to send to another node, right? To another node in the link. It has the IP address of the destination node, right? But you know, data link layer corresponds with the MAC address. That means it is hop-to-hop communication. We have studied way back, you know, that this IP datagram that is produced, you know, at so IP datagram that is received from network layer to what I mean to say data link layer, it has to be converted into frame. And a frame will always be containing MAC address of the next router or the destination host, or the next router or the destination host. This is what is there. Now, what happens when the host, sending host, knows the IP address of the destination and IP address of the next router, which is there on the this thing, but it does not know MAC address. But you know, this data link layer always communicates through MAC address, that is hop to hop address through MAC address. And the current host which is sending you know, pack a frame, it does not know MAC address of the next router, right? So what exactly will happen? So the IP address of next node is not helpful for the sending host, right? So because it's of no use for it, because data link layer will need a MAC address of the receiving node. Receiving node means in this case, it should be a router, intermediate router. So how should it get that MAC address of the next router nearest to it? So in this scenario, when the host is knowing the IP address of the receiving router, but it does not know MAC address of the receiving router, in that case, it will take the help of ARP. ARP means address resolution protocol, right? Which is application layer, whenever this thing is there. So ARP, I'll show where exactly it occurs. So ARP, address resolution protocol, becomes helpful. So here ARP protocol is auxiliary protocol generally defined in network layer. So we will see in diagram that ARP protocol is one of the auxiliary protocol defined in. Auxiliary means, meaning of the word auxiliary means supporting protocol. It is not the main protocol. It just supports in fetching the MAC address of router where the packet has to go through, where the frame has to go through towards destination. So this router happens to be intermediate node through which the frame will be going to destination. So ARP, that is why we call it as auxiliary protocol, and it will be defined always in network layer, and it belongs to the network layer. So ARP accepts the IP address from the IP protocol and maps the address to the corresponding link layer and passes it to data link layer. Now this is what happens. So here this is the diagram. So I have network layer where I'll have ICMP, I have IGMP, IP address will be taken and that will be sent to ARP and finding the link layer addressing. So here link layer address will be there. Now, anytime a host or a router needs to find link layer address of another host or a router in a network, it has to send ARP request packet. So now what ARP, we will shortly see the packet format of ARP protocol, ARP packet. So it has to send this is the host, right? This is the host sender. So this is sending host. And this is the router which is there, intermediate router. Now, this sending host knows IP address of this router. But for data link layer, it should know the MAC address of the router, MAC address of the router. You got the idea? This is what is required, MAC address of this router, but it knows only IP address. So this will be sending an ARP request source. This sending source will send the ARP request to this router telling that I need your MAC address. Now this router will respond with its own MAC address embedded in the ARP packet. So this router will send its own MAC address to the sender. The moment MAC address of this router comes to this sender, it now sends the datagrams. It is free to send the datagrams. So this is how the communication happens. Right. So now let us see. So here, as the sending host does not know the link layer address of the receiver, so query of the broadcast. Now, what it will do is sending host will send a broadcast ARP packet to all the hosts and routers that are connected to the network broadcast address. So we can see in this particular figure how exactly this goes. So here, every host or the router on the network will receive and process this ARP request packet. But only the intended recipient. Intended recipient means here there is a hitch. I should say this is the sender. You got the idea? Now it wants to send this is router R1, assuming that this is router R1 and this is router R6. Then this is a router, R35. This is router R35 and this is B. So B is the receiver. You got the idea? And this is the sender. You got the idea? This is the sender. So I have this node as a sender and this as a receiver. So this is a receiver. Now, there will be several routers. So this will be another router, right? This will be another router, right? And this will be another router, right? So this is a router K. This is router, 2. This is router 5. Right, this is router 5. Like this, it is there. Now, the sender, what it will do is, it does not know MAC address of now. The sender has to get the MAC address of this R1. So, what it will do, it will send a broadcast ARP message, which will be sent to this, whichever are connected to this particular sender directly, And every, router R2 will receive, ARP address. Router R1 will receive RP address and router R5 also receives the ARP address from sender S. But since the packet contains the IP address of R1 only, you got the idea, IP address of R1 only. So R1 understands that this ARP request is for me. This ARP request is for me, and where the sender wants to know the MAC address, my MAC address. So R1's MAC address, it wants to know. So these R2 and R5 will also process ARP, packet request, which has come from the sender. They will send it to data link layer, where the packet will be opened or decapsulated, and it is seen from which IP address is there. So that ARP packet does not contain IP address belonging to R2, and it does not contain IP address belonging to R5, because it is containing IP address of R1 only. So these two, R2 and R5, will destroy that particular ARP request packet because they don't need to respond. Only R1, what it will do after receiving this particular packet, it understands that the sender does not have my MAC address. So what it will do is it replies with ARP packet to the sending source, stating that this is my MAC address. So this is how the initial communication happens. So let us see next. So the response packet, now R1 understands that it is a packet belonging to me. And this packet now will do what R, after receiving the ARP request, it sends the reply ARP packet to the sender, and it is unicast mode. Unicast means it goes directly to the sender. It doesn't go to all other, this thing. And what information goes from there is the information about its MAC address of R1. It goes. So here the system on the left, A, now in this figure we will see, has a packet that needs to be delivered to another system called as B, happy having IP address N2. And system A needs to pass packets to data link layer for the actual delivery. You got the idea, but it does not know physical address of the recipient. So it uses the services of ARP. So the sender A has to use the services of ARP by asking it request to ARP protocol to send a broadcast ARP request packet. You got the idea, asking the physical address of the system with an IP address of N2. Right. So we will see this diagram. Now here, you can see the system A is there and system B is there. Now this system B either can be a host or a router. System B can be a host or a router. Here again, this particular system can be either a host, means computer, or a router. This can be a computer or a router. Now what it will do is, it is sending what I mean to say here N1, and N1 is the node, and L1 is the MAC address. So looking for link layer address of a node with IP address N2. So it will send the request packet. So request packet is C is going to all the systems. So it is going to node 4, it is going to node 3, it is going to node 2 also, right? But it has sent in request packet only the IP address of IP address means this N2. N2 is the IP address of system B. So here it goes over here. Now system B understands that I have been requested to provide my MAC address. So how does it respond? So it replies. Now system B replies. Now here you can see the request is a broadcast. It is going to all the routers that are connected connected to the system A. So here B, it knows that since the frame is containing IP address of N2, IP address N2, this is the system B with IP address N2. So it replies. You got the idea that my MAC address is L2. My MAC address is L2. So this is how. So here we have N1 is the IP address of system A. L1 is the MAC address of system A. N4 is IP address of this system, and L4 is MAC address of this, like this, can define. So it sends. So system B tells that I am node. You got the idea, with IP address N2 and my link layer address or MAC address is L2. So this goes as a unicast address. It has not gone here. It has not gone here. So it is directly one-to-one communication. This happens. Once system A knows the MAC address of system B, it starts sending the data directly to system B, not avoiding to send data to all these in broadcast mode.